Here I am in Robot Studio. I've manually selected this data, and on the right you'll see there's a list of things I have to do. The last one is select how the robot can capture more things. How can we find next item? And then below that we can click on select pagination setting. On this particular website, you'll see the list of items on the left. This one does scroll down to load more items. Let me show you. So when I scroll down a little bit here, keep going. At the bottom, you'll see an icon right here that shows there are more items loading. Let's go through the rest of the options. Click on next to navigate to the next page. This is an example here. I'm scrolling down my items, and when I scroll down far enough, you'll see this next icon. Next, let's look at an example of clicking on a load more button. On this website, when we scroll down, you'll see show more. In some cases, there may be no more items to load. Here on the Zapier website, you'll notice there are 8 items here. If we go to a different category, you'll see that it shows 1 to 22 of 30 items. So there are more here, but on the other category here, we know that it can show up to 22 and there are only 8, so it will not need to load more. And lastly, we have scroll up to load more items. I couldn't find a great example of this, but you can imagine it's the opposite of scroll down. In this example, I've used the AI assistant to automatically detect this, and it has chosen scroll down to load more items. We can click on review pagination setting to check that out and click confirm or reselect. When you do reselect, you can choose one of these other options if the one that was automatically selected was incorrect. In this case, it was correct. It was scroll down. So we'll go back and review and we will reselect and change it back. That's how to review and change. And that's just a little bit about pagination settings in Robot Studio.